We will start with some basics course in R. So before starting, it's much better that we create a working directory. A working directory is nothing but in a directory where you can store all your files, all your codes, all your data sets. So I have already created a folder called Imvergence, and in Imvergence I have already created R basics folder. I'll just copy this path, go to R. And in my editor terminal, I'll just make a working directory. So I have, for starting my working directory, I have to do set working directory. And in double quotes or single quotes, you just add your path and just do control enter. Here, I'm getting an error, and I did this purposely just to show you how this thing works. While entering path, if you are using forward slash, make sure you keep forward slash twice. Let me just change this. And then do control enter. If you don't like to work with forward slash, you can change it also. From forward slash you can do a backward slash, but you can do it only once. And this is how you set a working directory. Now in more tab over here, if you want to see your working directory, go to working directory. So here it's empty because we have not worked till now. If you want to comment in your code, so you can directly use hashtag and add comments over here. First we are going to start with variables. Variables are nothing but reserved memory locations to store values. So whenever you create a variable, you reserve a space in memory. To declare a variable, we use an assignment operator, which is something like this, or you can also use equal to sign. Let's give it a try. I am assigning x as a value of 87. Do control enter. Here you can see the global environment. X has already assigned a value of 87. Let's try to execute a string. Instead of this assignment operator, I am just using the equal to sign. To pass a string, make sure you use a double quotes. So let's do good evening. Do control enter and your string is passed. If you want to print X, you can directly just type X and do control enter, or you can do print X. Both are same. If you want to add something, let me just do this. X assign 7 plus 9. Do control enter. Here you can see X is updated. Again, to print X, you can do X control enter or run this print command. Let's try something else. You can also assign boolean values like true, false. Let me assign Z, put it as true. Do control enter. Let's print Z. If you wish to clean your global environment, there is an option given clear objects, so it will clear all the objects in the workspace. If you wish to clean your console, just do control L. If you wish to save your file, just go to file, go save as, and this file will be directly saved in your working directory. I'll just start with R basics dot, and I'm just giving the extension as dot r. The file is saved. Now we will try to print some sequence of numbers. Let me just give it a command over here. If I wish to print 1 to 20, so there is an operator called colon operator. I can directly use this. If I want to just print 1 to 20, 1 colon 20. Just press Ctrl Enter, and here you can see the numbers 1 to 20, including 1 and 20 both. Now you must be thinking that what this number in the left hand side corner are. So these numbers are nothing but the index. So here it will start from 1 up to 19, and your 20th number is printed over here. So it is giving the index number as 20. If you wish to print some other number, suppose I am just trying to print a sequence, or let's just print a number as pi, pi colon 10. Here the number of pi is printed and it is incremented by 1 till 10. Here you can't see anything number going more than 10. Let's try to print the sequence in different way. So either you can use this colon operator, or you can use this sequence command, SQ. So 1 comma 20. It will print a sequence from 1 to 20. Or there is another way, if you want to some partitions in between 1 to 20, 1 to 10, we can do sequence. Okay, let's check the documentation. To check the documentation, you can do question mark SEQ, okay, with a round bracket, press enter. Here you can see the documentation. Or what else you can do is you can just come put a cursor near sequence, press F1, your documentation will be coming. Or there's another way to check the documentation. Just do help, press the, just type the name of your function, SEQ, just do enter. Same way you can see the documentation. So there are various ways to check your documentation. Here I can see from and to and by. So I'll start an argument, just put it as from equals to 1 comma 2 equals to 10. I want a difference of 0.5, so I'll just put it as by equals to 0.5. Let's print the sequence. Here you can see the number is from 1 to 10, and the difference between one interval to another interval is 0.5. If you don't want to go with like from to, you can directly print your sequence. Not from, you can directly print the sequence like 1 comma 10 comma by equals to 5. Press Ctrl Enter. Let's save our work. Just press Ctrl S.